Last time when I spoke to you, I told you about the power that resides within us in this triangular bone called as sacrum, which is called as Kundalini, and which is responsible for giving us our second birth. In modern times, the search for truth is so widespread that it had to happen. It was also as if planned out that in modern times only, the people who are seeking the truth in various lives have to attain that awareness which will grant them the light of truth. The search is on. For example, a human being may be searching his joy in money, in power, in possessions, in seeking security for oneself, but the search of the seekers is on, and they have to find it. And that is possible in these modern times. It has to work out. But perhaps people are not aware that as the modern times are best suited for this seeking, for this enlightenment, also modern times are the worst times. The reason is, modern times are the times of confusion. Everything that we do, we are confused about. We are not sure as to what we are doing is correct or incorrect, whether we do it in money, in power, or about seeking. Because this is the time where your wisdom is tested. If you are wise, then you will choose wisely. And that's why a confusion is created, we can say, like a puzzle. So in modern times, life is much more puzzling than it was ever. Before this, life was much smoother, in the sense we lived in ignorance and ignorance was bliss. But seeking we must do. We can't do without it. This is the highest seeking that a man has to achieve. First, it started with food in the animal stage, continued with us. But now we are seeking something much beyond our comprehension. But we are seeking. We don't know what we are seeking. But we are seeking is a fact. Now the confusion is what to expect, then how to seek. These two points are there. But first of all, I would like you also to know that when the seeking of the saintly people, of the good people, of the righteous people, of the virtuous people is on, there is also a very powerful force of destruction is executing. There are people who do not want you to seek. There are people who want to make money out of your seeking. There are people who want to make you slaves out of your seeking. There are people who want to give you something by which you are destroyed. Your being is destroyed. This kind this kind of seeking, of destroying the seekers, has also built up into a very big force. It is not individualistic. Like we had in ancient times some rakshasas, some devils, who incarnated on this earth, whom the goddess had to fight. They came individually, one by one. They had their own armies, but one by one. But in modern times, perhaps all of them have taken birth, because they think this is the best time of confusion, when they can reap their harvest of evil. By this kind of a darkness around, it becomes even worse. It becomes even worse. The confusion is even much worse. We cannot understand how to seek them, how to find the right path. So many circuses are out, so many personalities are there with different kind of advertisements, and everybody supplying something, like as if in the market there's a demand and people are here to sell it off. Naturally, one would be quite worried and one would be quite thinking about it. This is simultaneous. But one must know if there are replicas, there has to be original. If there are plastic flowers, there have to be real flowers. Otherwise, how did they copy? Now, how to make out which is the truth? The point is, if it is our evolutionary process, and in that we are going to achieve the truth, that should happen to us in any case, normally. Because we have become human beings without putting any effort into it. So if you have to become a higher human being, it should happen to us spontaneously. So one thing should be there, there should not be any effort involved. This should be one of the criteria. Secondly, we have not paid a single pi for becoming a human being from chimpanzee, did we? We got it all free. You cannot pay for your evolution. You can pay for anything else, but not for your evolution. So you cannot pay. I mean, by paying or going through courses, you cannot do it. It is some sort of a living thing that is going to happen. We should see other living things. For example, a flower cannot become a fruit by paying any money to it. If it is a living process that is going to bring forth the fruit, then we cannot pay. Then we cannot put in any effort. It has to be spontaneously worked out. And then it has to be with us when we are born. The potentiality has to be with us when we are born. Like a seed has got the potentiality to become a tree, a flower has got a potentiality to become a fruit. In the same way, this potential power should be within us. Otherwise, how are we to become something else? How are we to be born again? If we come to that conclusion, then you say that it is born with you, that is sahaja, is born with you. It is with you. It is your own power within you, yourself. So what is the difference? The difference is that as human beings, now you have to know that you have become that. So far, up to this evolutionary process, it was not necessary for you to know that you have become from amoeba to a fish, and from fish to a turtle, and from a turtle to a pig, and then onwards you have become a chimpanzee, and from chimpanzee to human being. It was not necessary for you to know, but at this stage it is necessary that you should know. But why? Again the question comes in, because why is the problem of today? The question comes is, why still we should know? The question is all right, but answer is like this, that the evolutionary process till you became human beings were done when you had no freedom to choose. At this stage, you have freedom to choose, to develop yourself in such a way that you have freedom to choose. Now, once you have freedom to choose, you choose rightly. And rightly, when you choose, you get it. Because the evolutionary process now is a much higher thing, and meant for people of great caliber, not for cheap people, frivolous people, people who have no self-esteem. It is not. It is meant for people of great caliber. Those people are of very ordinary caliber, of ordinary nature, cannot get it to begin with. Later on, when this happens, this adventure is achieved by a few, many will follow. But to achieve this adventure, the beginning of it, can be done only through people who are truly seeking, people who are courageous, who would like to have the flight. And those who are not courageous enough, those who are not fully equipped for it, those who do not have that caliber, cannot achieve. Such people cannot face the truth. They cannot. It is beyond them. They just want to carry on with something which is very, very simple in the sense that which is compromising with their values and so-called weaknesses. For example, if I have to say that in Sahaja Yoga, you don't have to give up anything, but later on you suddenly give up, because your priorities change. You just give up those things which you could not live with, the things that had made you a slave, to which you got addicted. You just get rid of them because you become master of yourself. It happens spontaneously. It happens so spontaneously. But if you are not a person who is willing to understand that you are a slave of these things and you have been really enslaved and it's going to carry you into a ditch later on, then you may just leave the place and think, oh God, this is too much for me. If a transformation takes place, naturally your priorities will change. For example, there is no light in this room. So how you walk, groping everything. But if there is light, you become straight and you walk straight to your seat. In the same way, when there is enlightenment within you, your priorities change. And you become a master of yourself, absolutely a master. You are no more enslaved by anything. Nothing can guide you. You start guiding your own destiny and the destinies of many by giving them enlightenment yourself. Now these dark forces that are here can only be neutralized by the force of divine love. People talk of love, but they have no idea as to what divine love is. They have no idea whatsoever, because It is said in Gita, the one who sees can only see. The one who does not see cannot see. It's a very simple thing. No use talking to people who cannot see. But I would say, why not make them see the thing? Supposing they see the thing, then all the priorities change. Not only that, you get a transformation in your awareness, you become dynamic and aware. You start understanding. Will you sit down? These children should not disturb in the hall. You start understanding the problems within you, because you are separated from yours. You start understanding the problems in other people. For example, when the center in your being, as shown here, are excited by this power of Kundalini, then these centers are empowered, sort of recharged. And the centers which are controlling the plexuses outside on the gross plane also enrich those plexuses, and first thing that happens to us, that we improve physically to such an extent that even cancer is cured. I mean, cancer can only be cured by sahaja, by no other way. When the Kundalini rises slightly higher than that, then you reach one of the centers there, the fourth center of the heart, where your sense of security is established. Once the sense of security is established, your mental problems start dissolving. Those who suffer from mental problems become better off. Their mental conditions improve. But normally a person who is mentally handicapped in the beginning finds it difficult, because he gets suggestions like the gentleman who was here just now. They just can't bear it. They just run away. But if you have patience, you can work on them, and you can cure mental patients. As we have cured epilepsy of the worst type, there are some people sitting here who had epilepsy of the worst type. They would have been in mental hospitals. Once your sense of security is established, your mental condition becomes normal. But one has to have little courage. There's nothing to be frightened in Kundalini awakening. She is your mother, and she loves you, and she has been born again and again with you, and she's just waiting for this chance to happen. If it happens, you'll be amazed how you get changed. Now here you know there are at least 50% people, maybe more, who are realized souls and who have got this. But when this Kundalini rises higher, to this position, then a person becomes a witness. He just feels that the drama is over. He is not involved anymore. And then he becomes dynamic. Because if you are involved in a situation, you cannot do anything about it. You are all the time frantic or worried or looking at your watches and things like that. But if you are above it, then you can solve your problem better. You become a sakshi, a witness, which Sri Krishna has said, Christ has said, Muhammad has said, that you have to become a sakshi, a witness. This is just a drama going on, and you are involved into it. The drama breaks through. And once this drama breaks, you start seeing it and you start laughing at it, at yourself also. That, why was I worried? This is just a drama. And then, when the Kundalini rises even higher, at that point and process it, you become thoughtlessly aware. There is no thought in your mind. You do not think anymore. You become silent. One thought arises and falls off, another arises and falls off. In between this thought, you just stand in the present. You become. And when the Kundalini pierces the last center, this one, then a cool breeze starts flowing from your hand. You start feeling the power flowing through. First time the central nervous system is feeling. At this time you will be amazed, all the five centers here and six and seven centers start indicating, in the sense that all of them get enlightened. And if you place your hands like this, suddenly you find there's a tingling going on in here, or in here, or in here. And these all demarcate the centers which are in problem within you. On the left side or the right side? Well, the left side is the emotional side and the right side is your physical and mental side. You start understanding yourself that here is the problem which is within us. For example, Brighton has a problem on here, mainly. Now, these times for unauthorized working of God's power. For example, there must be a lot of black magic going on here. There must be a lot of people who are doing all kinds of guru vidya and all those sort of things which should not be done. Means people who are not authorized to do God's work are doing. This means that. And this percentage is quite a lot. And when this center is spoiled, which is very difficult because this encompasses even your mind and you get ideas from these people. And you are so ruined by them that it is very difficult for you to see the truth. That's why again and again I come to Brighton, because I know you have one great advantage, that is of sea. And how much the sea can take away also I don't know, but there are lots and lots of people who are practicing these bad things here. They perform all kinds of so-called miracles. For example, they remove this one from here to there. Now what does it matter in the eyes of God? Just think of it. Can't you remove yourself? They may give you a diamond just like this. You'll think, oh God, I've become so very rich. You might be having 10 diamonds first, then they give you one diamond. Take away all the 10. Why should God give you diamonds? What are diamonds for God? Just dust of his feet? To human beings it's all important, bank balance, this thing. God doesn't operate all these things. He creates all the diamonds of the world. Why should he worry about giving you diamonds? All nonsense it is. Then there are some people who may show another kind of miracle, like mesmerizing. They really mesmerize. And you get enamored by it, like some people start jumping, taking out their clothes. Why will God do that? Well, by taking out your clothes, do you become God? Can you become? I mean, how do you get evolved? After all, you used to wear clothes, now are you going to take it out? For so many years you have been wearing. Before that you never wore any clothes. So are you going to now become very much realized if you take out your clothes and start jumping like mad. Then some people say that you can jump like a frog. There was one person in Kolhapur, he was sitting with both his legs towards me. So some of the Sahaja Yogis went and said, you can't sit like this towards Mother. He said, I'm sorry, if I just pull my legs, I will start hopping like a frog. So then I called him, I said, why should you hop like a frog? He said, my guru told me that when Kundalini awakens, you start hopping like a frog. And mine is already awakened and I'm hopping like a frog. All the time I'm hopping like a frog. I said, now if your Kundalini is awakened, are you going to become a frog after becoming a human being? Well, you have to become something higher or lower animal. Tomorrow you will be twisting like a worm and you will say, I have to become a worm. Then there are some people who are going out for flying. There are some here who went out for flying also. Thousands of pounds they have spent for a bluffer who just bluffed them. They should have asked the fellow to fly to begin with, you see, drop him from some from tower, you see this, what you call leaning tower of Pisa. That's the best place, I would say. Take him up there and drop him from there and see how far he can fly. It's very easy to do that, to find out. But no, people paid a lot of money. And then we should think, are we going to become birds now? It is nowhere in the scripture said that you will be flying in the air. From where do you get this idea? Anybody comes with such ideas, why should people take it? Now you'll be surprised, we laugh at it. But there are 100,000 people, these Britishers, who are known for their wisdom. Only Britishers, I'm saying. There are altogether 2 million people in the whole world who are following this man who is teaching flying. Can you believe such stupidity, such mass stupidity existing? Because it happens, because these are simple people, they are mesmerized, absolutely mesmerized, to such an extent that they cannot think, their thinking is zero. Out of which these people who have come to me, I have seen. They were in the most miserable states, and even today they are, and it's acting like a mafia. Nobody can say that they are in that condition. This is the stupidity to which we succumb. When we are mesmerized, we cannot even think. We do not know how we are going, what are our moorings, how we have to move. We just go on under the blanket, black blanket, and once we discover we are lost, we find that we are in the lunatic asylum or in the jail. From the same lot we have had people who were in coma for 10 days, just different like this. Nobody knew this kind of a disease. This has come out of the so-called flying business, for which you pay and become a lunatic. So it is necessary also to see other people who... And it's very sad, because these are all saints and seeking God, who have been tortured and looted by these people. This I've been saying from 1970 loudly. I've taken their names and flouted them and spoke everywhere I went. I spoke in America and everywhere I told that don't trust these people, don't trust these people. But nobody would listen. Recently I went to Bristol, I believe, where some Indians had come and some others had come. And the people said, Mother, we are surprised that a guru had come here about a year back, and there were thousands to see him. And this guru had no credibility of any kind. He came from right from South Africa. And suddenly there were thousands to meet him. And this guru has now been found out to be a drunkard and has got 5-6 kids. What is his credibility? From where does he come? He says, I have a big business, whatever it is. Why is he here? It is also necessary that we should find out what sort of a life the person leads. Now, what should we expect to happen? I have told you that you become, there is an actualization of the experience, that you become that superior person, endowed with supreme power of love. You become that. It is not only giving you a lecture that you are brothers and sisters and treat everyone very happily and they are all your own. It's not lecturing, it's not brainwashing. It's an actualization, it should happen to you. You should become that. You should feel others within yourself. You should feel others are part and parcel of your being. Then only it is true. Otherwise we have got United Nations, we have got so many organizations, brothers and sisters organizations I call them, all put together. But it is all rational. It's not the thing happening within yourself. But when the Kundalini rises, she enlightens the spirit in your heart. And then the projection of the heart quality, which is divine love, starts manifesting and you start feeling in your heart a cool breeze. The cool radiance, the cooling radiance of the heart. It is described as the cool breeze of the Holy Spirit. This is a happening again and again, I'm telling you. It's not just telling you something that this should happen and you should become like this. Now it takes only split of a second. You are just ready for it. How much time does it take to like this? Just split of a second. But supposing the wick is not all right, the petrol is not all, I mean the oil is not all right, there's a problem in here or something, then it takes time to be corrected. If you are absolutely a normal person, it should be done. And once it is arisen, it doesn't fall down. But we have noticed that it doesn't work out that way. It's many of us. Many people who get realization go back home and lose it. And they give it up. This is another type of thief. They find it is too much. Or I don't know what they find. But if you take, say, £100 from a person for a course on Sahaja Yoga, which you cannot, then they'll come on. Because they'll think we have paid £100, better go through. It's a funny human nature. And how to make this divine love fit into it is a very difficult. Unless any human being rises up to a certain position of self-esteem, it doesn't fit into that. They have to recognize their realization. They have to understand that you have got it, that you have to establish yourself. So I do not know how to make these two things meet. For example, it is very easy to pamper your ego and take out all the money you have in your purse, all your properties and everything. It's the easiest thing to do is to pamper your ego and tell you lies. But by that you do not gain anything. Now, if I have to give you something, I have to make you equal to it, isn't it? If there's something lacking, if there's a hole in a picture, how are you going to fill in the gap? So you fill in the Ganges, go home, find the whole Ganges is disappeared. And you think now it's not working. Come back. The hole can be filled in. The hole can be again fixed. And you can be repaired. And you have to contain within yourself. You have to contain within yourself that power. So many of you have done it. Now in England we say, we have lots of people, lots and lots and lots, who have done it. And all over the world we have to do it. Of course in India, in the villages of India I should say, not in the cities. Cities are meant for all these money makers, not for me. I am not interested in Indian cities. People who are in the city, even the Indians over here, I don't know how far I'll work out with that. I'm sorry, but it's a fact. Same in India, the city dwellers are getting sophisticated now. But the villagers, who still are innocent and simple people, get it. In thousands, we've got the films of people, how they get it and how they work it out. It's spreading like fire, especially in Maharashtra. Also, it started in other places and I'm sure it will work. Now we have to see how many of you are willing to take up the challenge. It's a question of challenge. To you, to achieve it, and to establish it, and to know that you have all the powers, all the potential powers within you. Just you have to get it. Just you have to get it. You need not be a big minister for this. On the contrary, they are difficult. Rather difficult. Such people are quite difficult because they have a very big ego in the head. You see that yellow stuff? It covers the whole head of so many of these people. They are rather difficult. You have to be a noble person. Saman means audit. If you are over successful, the ego has to be punctured somewhere. Otherwise, too much, very big, the kundalini cannot enter. If there is a balance of ego and superego in your head, then it will clear. But even if you have ego, it can be given balance, you can be cured. Even if you have sickness, it can be done. Everything can be done. But today the time has come where thousands can get their realization and can be established because the last judgment has started. The last judgment is going to be through kundalini awakening. As if kundalini is the pointer in the balance. It has started. People are not aware that it has started. They do not want to be judged as yet, but time should not be lost. But this judgment is so beautiful that when you are judged, you get powers of your own, of your love. You enjoy the bliss of your spirit. You become so peaceful. All the tensions disappear. You become so dynamic. And the blessings of all the well-being come on you, as Krishna has said, yoga kshema vahamya. First the yoga, then the kshema. Kshema is the well-being. If you have not achieved your yoga, the kshema is not there. People say, I am speaking Advaita of Shankaracharya. Of course, it is the same. Whether it is Shankaracharya or anybody. I am doing that, only he was preaching, I am doing. What Christ said, what Krishna said and what Muhammad said is nothing but Advaita, that you have to become one with God. But there are many who do not like it. They want to have Advaita. They want to keep their personality, so-called, with them. I asked the other day one gentleman who was a minister and all that. I said, what do you want to keep back? What fit part? He said, not my ego. I said, then what is it? Then? It's that only. You want to keep back your ego. Unless and until you become big, you cannot evolve. And how do you become big? By becoming the ocean yourself. A small drop becomes an ocean as soon as he becomes one with the ocean. You become one with the awareness of God. This is what Christ has said, you are to be born again. It's said by everyone, Moses has said it, everyone has said it. But people are telling you, no, that should not be done. Because these middle agencies will be losing their income. How will they exist without it? Try to see this one. Achieve your own power of love. Achieve yourself. Become yourself. If you want it, you can have it. But if you don't want it, nobody can force this. Nobody can take away your freedom. If you want to remain as you are left to yourself. Then you face it up and live with it. But if you want the ultimate, the absolute, it is there. That's the only way you can get rid of your confusion and get rid of all your ideas of relative existence, political, economic and everything, can be only dissolved through achievement of your absolute. Because after realization you can feel. You can ask any absolute question, for example, if you want to ask a question, is there God? Immediately, the cool breeze starts coming. Submit, the answer comes. As if like a computer you start working out because you are put to the main. So, it is necessary for the whole humanity to pay attention to this. Because the time is coming when the sorting out will take place. That time, nobody is going to persuade or tell you and fill the hall and request. The sorting out will be there. Better get it now and establish. Whole humanity is to be saved. No use doing patchwork. Do something substantial. Substantial is only possible if you go to the roots of this tree of life and nourish it, enlighten it. That's the only way one can do. May God bless. If there are any questions, please ask. Please ask me questions, but sensible ones. Not like this that Mr. X has written in a book somewhere. That is not necessary. Do not develop controversies. You are here to achieve something, not to just get into arguments and discussions. If you have any questions, you can ask. Just raise your hand. Which one you are asking? All right. यहाँ पे कोई आ जाओ तो छाया या someone, somebody can come. Anybody can come. Marcus, can you come down here just to see what he's saying? I don't follow it. What is he saying? But it is. Come here. What it like to be? What is? What in life is correct, all right? You, if you are the... you are the... That you should answer yourself. These are the questions. You are quite good at it. Now, the first is a very good question. What is enlightenment? Second one is a little embarrassing. Is if I am the one who sustains it. I'll answer the first one. Begin with, all right? What is enlightenment? Let us start with an analogy. Yes, that's a good idea. It is right. It's a good idea. Yeah. Say, in this room, there is darkness. All right? There's no way of judging things because you can see through your eyes only if there is light. All right? And you come in the room, you find this door, you think, oh, door is the one, somebody sits on the chair, he says, chair is the one, somebody says the bench, he says, bench is the one. It's so relative. You do not know which is the truth. All right? You put on the light. What do you know? Oh, it's all there. In different places. It's placed here, placed there. It's like this. And these are removable, these are not removable, these are fixed things. Everything you see, all right? This is enlightenment. Now what, in the real sense, what happens? When you get enlightenment within yourself, is a deeper enlightenment. This is the enlightenment outside. But you get the enlightenment within yourself. Then what do you start seeing and feeling? You start feeling your different centers on your fingers. You start understanding what is wrong with you, what centers. You see the different colors you have got here. You know that this center is catching means this finger, supposing as I told you, this one is catching. This is on the left-hand side of the Swadhisthana Chakra, which is on the left-hand side. With this also you get the knowledge, I mean you are told how to correct it. Supposing you are catching on the right-hand side. Take a very concrete example. Maybe you are a liver patient. You are suffering from liver. And mostly all of you suffer here in this country. Because you think too much. Now you will be amazed to know that by thinking you suffer from liver. Nobody can believe, doctors won't believe. But this center, this yellow center, when it moves on this side, right side, it converts the fat of the stomach for the use of your brain. So when you are thinking too much, it is working it out very fast. And when it is working it out very fast, it has no time to look after your liver, which is supposed to be its domain. And this is the center with which you think. And around it, the overactivity of this center creates a tension. And this center goes into a terrible thinking process. You cannot stop your thinking. Just go on, gallopingly thinking. It's like, you can say, a cancer of thinking, people do. They cannot control their thinking. Uncontrollable thinking creates a problem, and then this center is not responsible anymore for your liver, you get a bad liver. There are other things also to spoil your liver, in addition to that. Now you discover only that your liver is not all right. Now you also know how to cure your liver. So you know physically what's wrong with you, you know mentally what is wrong with you, you know emotionally what is wrong with you, you also know what are your imbalances, what are your abnormalities. You know them on your fingers because this is all decoded. This decoding can be tested again and again and see for yourself with others. I'll tell you an example, a simple example. Somebody got realization in London. He's an archaeologist. And when I told him, he could not believe it. One day he started getting a little burning here. And he asked me, what's the matter with this? I said, these are the centers of your father. And this is the center of the throat. So you can telephone to your father and find out whether he's down with bronchitis. He telephoned to his father in Scotland. His mother came on the phone and she said that father is down with bronchitis. It is so much dynamically communicated. You are not enlightened about yourself, but enlightened about others. You put your hands towards someone, when you are sensitive enough, you can immediately say what's wrong with the person. Also, you know how to cure it and how to work it out. But with enlightenment, you enter into the kingdom of God. You become the citizen of kingdom of God. Means all the angels and all the ganas and all the great people of the heavens start helping you, and you are amazed at the miracles that happen. How it works out is something so surprising that one by one you start seeing the whole drama and you are amazed as if you are held by angels and helpers. When you are enlightened, you are absolutely blissful. There's no tension anymore because the energy starts flowing into you all through. We can give another analogy. When you are in the water, the waves of water frighten you, that you may be drowned. But supposing by any chance you are put on a boat or learn swimming, you start enjoying those waves. In human beings only we can learn how to swim, overcome this. And then this is an overall enlightenment, overall, in everything. Even say, for example, people who never knew a word about decorations and art and aesthetics suddenly become aesthetic because of this enlightenment of the same center. Every center, when enlightened, has a new dimension within you opened up. Say for the example, the first center that is down below, if it is enlightened through Sahaja Yoga, you gain back your innocence, which you have lost. Absolutely. Innocence is a very big power within us, which starts manifesting. And you can overcome all kinds of evil things. If there's a man with evil ways, he approaches you. He'll be neutralized. He will be transformed. He'll become very kind, extremely kind. The second center has got the power of creativity. You get the creativity which is living. So far, you never had. We take everything from the nature. We have never given anything to the nature. When this center is enlightened, then when you get, say, vibration, say, to a field of wheat. In India, they have done experiments in many universities of agriculture, and we have many scientists there who are doing this. They are Sahaja Yogis. And they have found out that the same seed, if it is vibrated, can produce 5 times more wheat. Not only that, but they store that wheat in a big store where there were other things stored up. And the rats did not touch those bags, gunny bags, which contained those. It's worth seeing all this. There were cows, Indian cows do not give as much as the milk, as much as the other cows like, you can say, New Zealand or Australian cows. But these two type of foreign cows are extremely aggressive, and their milk makes people very, very aggressive. And the taste is not so good. But Indian cows give very nice milk, which doesn't make people very aggressive, and the taste is good. But the Indian cows, when they were given vibrations, supposing they were given 5 sear of milk, they started giving at least 10 sears or 12 sears. Not so much as these aggressive ones were given, but their longevity increased. This is how you start giving these enlightened dimensions to think. For example, see this fire now here. I put my hand there. I can enlighten this fire. You'll be amazed if this is enlightened. It can take away all your problems. Even with one candle light, you can take away so many candles. It's worth seeing. There was a person who was possessed, and we told him a method of working it out with one candle. And the whole wall started becoming black, with the black coming out of that. And he couldn't understand it, but he got cured completely. Means you can enlighten all the elements with these vibrations. The water gets the power to wash you inside out, your sins and your problems. The light gives you the power by which you can burn off and fire out all the wrong things which are spoiling. Your skin becomes lustrous. You start looking very much younger than your age. You are absolutely relaxed. You become extremely kind, and you enjoy your virtues of kindness. You never repent it. The first thing that happens to most of you, that you start laughing aloud. You have someone here who really laughed in distance when he found himself. At himself he said, I laughed. Where was I? What was I doing all this? There are 1001 things what enlightenment. But enlightenment actually means that your being is enlightened. Means it has achieved the power of emitting love, of divine love. It means you have become a hollow personality, that the divine love is flowing through. That on your central nervous system you start feeling that flow through your being. It just emits. Like Christ says, somebody touched him, that something passed out of me, that energy of love. I hope, just now I cannot give the whole thing, but it will satisfy. And the second part, it if I sustain. All right, I would say, if I am the gardener, I have to look after the seeds, isn't it? But it is your own. For the time being, I may. For example, this light goes out, you put it on, again you go on looking after it, because that's my job, is to enlighten it. So till it takes its own form of light, I look after it. I do look after it. But if I say sustain, then I would say you sustain it. But I look after it, and I make you sustain also. Is there anything wrong? If you could do it, I would be very happy. Really, it's a tremendous task, isn't it? Hazardous thing to maintain it. Even to raise kundalini is not easy. I have to carry all that load upon myself. And day in and day out, I'm working very hard, you can ask me. It's too much of a task. It's not an easy thing. People can't believe that somebody can do it just for love's sake, for nothing at all, for no payment. They just can't believe it. You have to see it and then believe. All right? You have to tell me loudly. Voice is very low today. Yeah. I think ask somebody else, his throat is not all right. Maureen, just listen to this. Mark, you can. What did he say? Mark, what is it? Yes. Come here, come. You come here and tell me. Yes, it's better. Today I'm traveling so much, my ears are buzzing a little. Huh? Absolutely spiritual. The complete is, I'm saying, the manifestation of the spirit takes place. You see, the spirit, when it starts manifesting, what happens? You become collectively conscious. You become, I say. You become collectively conscious. Spiritual is that you become that. Yes, that is what happens. That is what happens. No, no. It goes down because, you know, Kundalini is the sustainer within you. As I said, you are your own sustainer. You see, the Kundalini goes up. It gives light in different places. And at the first sight, it shoots off and it gives you realization, you touch it. But if you have problems, then she goes and looks after that. It's the Kundalini that sustains you, isn't it? So she goes and looks after you. Then she goes another part, she looks after you. Till she has repaired you, she comes and goes. Then she establishes. It takes some time. No, it is. No. It is a power within you. See? You see? No. It is a power within you to connect you to with the whole. You are not yet connected with the whole. You see, the whole is all-pervading power of divine love. Then you get connected with it. It's a connection. All right, the connection is within you. See, now for example, the electricity is in these lights, all right? But it has to flow through something, isn't it? All right, in the same way. You are connected by this Kundalini to that spirit which is universal in nature. But supposing I am, should I commit it to you? Because you'll crucify me if I say that. You wouldn't, are you sure? You would not, but if I say that, you see, if I have to say that, it's a fact. Otherwise, how will I raise the Kundalini if there was nothing about me? You understand my point? But I'm tactful. Why? I've learned a lesson. Krishna's times were different. He didn't tell anybody, he just told Arjuna. He didn't tell anybody. Did he tell anybody? Only Christ. Yes, but no, he just told Arjuna, that's all. He didn't tell anybody else. Be careful on that point. Now, then another one was Christ, who just said, I am the light, I am the path, he was crucified. So I've learnt a lesson in this life. I'm not going to tell the whole thing, but I will later on. Of course, there's something about me, no doubt about it. Yes, now they understand this. Now this question comes in, how can I raise the Kundalini? There must be something about me. No, not at all. No, not at all. See, now there is light here. But it is being burning. This is not physical in the sense that it is coming out of that, or electricity is passing through that. So energy can pass through something material. Energy doesn't become material. Energy is energy, all right? So this energy is contained there. It is the energy that is, it passes through the channels which are within, you see? And then you become all-pervading, you can see yourself, you become that. No. Just now let it happen. What I'm saying, let us see. If it... That's all. I know, that is the point. Yes, yes. That's what. I'll tell you about... This is a very good point you have brought. Now sit down, I'll tell you. Sit down. Now I'll tell you what it is. Not physical, it is a thing. What you are saying is correct, that Kundalini burns people, must burn. Those horrible people who try, they have no right to do. Supposing energy of electricity is there. It's not material, it's energy, isn't it? Agreed? Coming through a plug, you put your hands there and you get a shock. Will you say that the energy is nothing but gives you shock? And what about these lights? The one who knows how to handle can only handle the energy. Everybody can. Those people who try to handle Kundalini have to have a very holy nature. They should have an authority. Because it is unauthorized, when they try, they get all these problems. Any energy can burn. The same energy which is now giving here light can burn the whole house if you don't know how to handle it. So that energy which is handled by wrong type of people will definitely burn them and give them heat. But it is not that. What happens, the waves of cool. Always energy moves in waves, isn't it? The material things do not move in waves. It starts moving in your hand, you can feel, like the energy flow. And the proof of the pudding is in the eating. If it is all-pervading power, you can see, just now I gave you an example, how a person could discover. You can also discover if a person is realized soul or not. For example, your Stonehenge in England. People have written so many books about it, they don't know a word. When I went there, I said, these are the stones which came out of the Mother Earth. They are all vibrating, you can feel it. They are spiritual. How can you make out a realized soul? How can you make out a realized soul? You put your hands towards the person, you can easily say he's not a realized soul. If you are a realized soul yourself, otherwise you cannot. Understand? If a person is a realized soul, if a person has got spiritual powers or not, how will you make it out? Can you? Can you make it out? All of them. Those who are realized, all of them can make it up. Sitting down here, even those who are dead, they can make it up. Because if they are spiritual, if they are really realized souls of that level, you can make it up. There are many fake people who think they are very spiritual. You can make it up. Then there is no doubt about it. I'm happy you are so much interested in spiritual part. You see, because I start talking about spirituality, most of them disappear. So I have to start from physical, then mental, then emotional, and give them the spiritual. It's the spiritual only. I'm happy on this point, very much with you. That is the concern if Kundalini is really a spiritual thing. It is, 100%. It's spirit. Spirit is, can be only enlightened through this energy of Kundalini. There's no other way. But in this country, people are more rational and they just start thinking. So they have to be taken round and round. But in India, people understand it very fast. It is the way to get out of your bhavasagara, illusion, the maya. All right? Just sit down. You cannot argue it out. You have to find it. It has no form, of course. What is the form does it have? What form does it have? You tell me, Krishna had a form or not? He had a form, isn't it? Christ had a form, all right? But it was flowing through that form. It has no form, but it flows through a form. It is not. What is the text about? I'll teach you Gita again. You see what I'm saying? There's a very great Gita teacher in London. Now he's learned the Gita a new way after the enlightenment. And I think you better go to him and learn it from him again. The thing is, what Krishna has said is the same what I have said. Only thing, the style he has said it is different. Because, you see, he knew that human beings are mediocre at that stage. So he just went round. He didn't tell you directly that you better get your realization. He should have. He did not. He played a diplomat. He told that you do your karmas and put the fruit of the karmas at the feet of the Lord. You cannot do it. You cannot, unless and until you are connected with that energy. He put absurd conditions, because he knew people were fools, they would not listen, they'll argue. So he said, all right, give them round and round then, till they reach a conclusion that no, this is not the thing. He is very clever, but I am straightforward. He said, Pushpam, Phalam, Toyam, whatever you have got, I'll take. While giving, it comes to, he says, Ananya Bhakti. See, the word Ananya is very important. Ananya means that when you are not alone, or when you become one with that energy, it means Ananya. In everything, whatever he has said it, he tried first to say the truth. He said, you should get the jnana, is the enlightenment of your awareness. But when he found that Arjuna said that you are saying you should become a sakshi and then ask me to go to war, he said, he's a mediocre. I can play the same trick on you, but I do not want to. Because it's time now for you to get it. What he said, enlightenment of your awareness is jnana. You have read Gita, translated by people who are not realized. The one I met recently was Mascaro, he's a realized soul. And he was very different. He's written many books. He's translated Gita, Dhammapada and all that. And he said, Mother, the one who knows, knows. He recognized me in no time because he's a realized soul. Ya sa pashyati sa pashyati. The one who can see, can see. The first thing he said was, how are you going to? I said, all right, I'll make them see. Krishna did not do that. That's 6,000 years back. That was the situation. But today it is not. It's the all-pervading power of divine love. I've said 100 times, but you have got some ideas fixed in your head. You never heard me say it. You become that power. It has no form. It is all pervading. Everybody heard me that. You can see in my tape also the same. But if you come with fixed ideas, you will get fixed to it and you will never go to the right point. Now better have it. I mean, if you get it, well and good, but if you don't get it, I can't help you. Depends on. It's not a simple thing. It has worked with so many of them. May not work out with it. It does, of course, help you. As Krishna himself has said, yoga kshema vahamyam. You understand Sanskrit? Yoga means first you must have realization and then the kshema. Kshema means well-being. Well-being takes place. That's what I told you. What is the well-being? But yoga must take place. This is also I said in my lecture, but you never heard me. So do not get your ideas fixed. In all these books, what are you seeking? Enlightenment. Get that. No use reading books also. Kabira has said, padi padi pandita murakha bhaye. He says, by learning too much, even the learned have become stupid people. It's very true. Because they will go on saying, like Nanaka has said, that you have to find it within yourself. They'll go on saying, you have to find it within yourself, you have to find it within yourself. Singing the song. Supposing I have a headache, I say, take a medicine. I go on singing, I have to take a medicine, I have to take a medicine. Who is going to take the medicine? The reading is like that. It's all paroksha, it's outside. Better get it. A gentleman sitting next to you has got it, and one step here has got it. And they also know where you are stuck up. This is what is sahaja. If they have got it, why not you? You should also get it. All right? But over-reading conditions mind. And the Gita you have read, I don't know whose Gita you have read. Have you read Mascaro's Gita? Your reading is very then little.